is I'm calling it AppSec Pipelines and Event-Based Security, moving beyond a traditional security test. And this is an evolution of a talk that I started probably 3 years ago with this weird amorphous idea. And then I tried the first implementation of it, and I'm sort of on the second implementation of it. I'm going to kind of talk through its evolution and where it may or may not make sense for you. And I have some examples, too, from people, including a couple emails while I was listening to the keynote from very late additions to this deck. But they're all here, so here we go. So yes, I'm Matt Tesauro. How long have I been in this space? Like 17-ish years? I don't really remember. I have an undergrad in economics and a master's in MIS from Texas A&M University. I taught at A&M, I've taught at UT, University of Texas. I forget I'm not in Texas. There is actually not Texas. I've worked for a bunch of different companies as a pen tester and run AppSec programs internally. And now I'm, like you said, I'm a full-time person at OWASP trying to make things better for OWASP projects. So, I think historically and traditionally, we treated AppSec much like the automotive industry treated making cars. You had custom coach workers that would make the car you wanted, the custom car, and it was really awesome. It was really expensive, and it took a really long time. And if you look at how traditionally we've done testing, because I did this when I was first doing AppSec, I wanted a week testing window, right? I wanted that 1 week of testing where I could go all the way through the app and test all the things and do all the stuff. But honestly, that doesn't scale, right? In that place, I was the only AppSec person with 120-ish apps, and I couldn't keep up there. And we had a QA that gave me a two-week window, which was unusual anyway. So my proposition is that we kind of need to do what this guy did, right? Henry Ford said, you know, cars are cool and cars are awesome, but they're really expensive and only a few people can buy them and they take forever to make. So I'm going to make you the car of your dreams as long as it's a black Model T, right? But I can crank those suckers up really fast and make a lot of them and drive the cost down. And I would like to see us have this happen in the AppSec world, because I think it needs to. We can't keep up. I mean, I really got sort of a smack in the face when I worked at Rackspace, and one of the teams was doing pushes to production. Their average was 75 times a week. So you tell me where my testing window is in 75 pushes to production a week, right? It doesn't exist. So like, take that traditional idea of testing with the 1 week of window to do your magic and chuck it out the door and completely rethink everything. And that's kind of what inspired this thought process. So my proposal here is that AppSec programs cannot scale to fit today's need, particularly if you're doing CI and CD, right? And we need to change. And I'm going to tell you how I've tried to adapt to that change in the environment, and also how a couple other companies have and what the results are. Oh, and this was kind of the bow shot, I think. For me, I stayed up way too late when this book arrived from Amazon and read this guy. If you haven't read it, please go. Don't get it now, but you can order it now. Just don't start reading it now. I did this. I have the same slide in a course I taught, a two-day course. I think it was at AppSec US, or it might have been the one at LastCon, where one of the students bought the book the night after day one and came back all bleary-eyed, swearing at me on day two. I was like, damn it, I was up till 3 a.m. reading that book. Why don't you tell me about this on day two? Oh, I'm sorry. So don't buy it now, but do read it. And this book, to me, was kind of the bow shot. It kind of gave, if you read this book and look at how they portray the security guy, he's a dude, he's rude, he's an idiot, he has not a clue. And he kind of gets a clue in the book, which is good. I think this is a great, great way to get a feel for how we're perceived by not us, which is kind of important, because our purpose is really to tell the business what the security posture of their apps are, right? At the end of the day, we're a business. Most of us are working for businesses. I'm now working for a charity, but I did work for a business, and that business paid my gave me a paycheck, and I kind of wanted that paycheck to happen so the business has to make money, right? And there is a business reason that'll decide what the tolerated level of risk is, and that isn't necessarily perfect. Yoda, who's going to drop into the dev department and give them some sense, right? That is our perception of how AppSec is. Like, we're the smart guys who come in and teach these developers who are wild and crazy how to use the security force to make their lives better. But honestly, if you talk to a developer, this is how they see us, right? We continually call their baby ugly and are not particularly helpful, right? This is, to me, the other graphic I didn't get the time to do, and I'm not good at graphics. I stole a lot of these configure. And it's really long and ugly, and there's some false positives, and maybe some of the stuff is actual, maybe it isn't, but by the way, read it. And you're used to looking at GitHub issues or maybe Jira tickets, but hey, too bad. Here's a big PDF. So we're not even speaking their language, you can't expect respect. So, this whole talk changed. I completely rewrote the talk 2 nights ago in the hotel. After hearing, I get The Economist in audio, and there was this great article about actually foreign companies' perception of doing business in the U.S., and it really reminded me of what the perception of devs is, of the security people coming in and talking to them, right? And the perception, or the push of this article was that
Yeah.